Hello, everybody. Welcome. New season, and good to see some familiar faces. Any questions? I'm happy to answer.
How do you like the tempo, especially starting out? How do your team maintain it throughout the game?
Well, I thought our team played a very up-tempo game tonight. We pressed. They pushed the ball, and I thought they were smart. We had a couple careless turnovers in the last 3 minutes. But for the most part, I thought they played within themselves and while they were playing fast.
You talk about the play of Jordan McLaughlin tonight, 24.
Well, Jordan had shot the ball well. He was 8 for 12 from the field. I was very impressed with his teammates of finding him when he was open. I thought Elijah Stewart, Kate Reinhardt, Julian Jacobs, Malik Marchetti, the other guards were in the game, really found Jordan when he was open, and Jordan was able to make plays.
Do you think it was easy for this team to adjust with the shot clock moving down from 30 seconds?
We don't even notice it. 35, 30. We try to get a shot off quicker than 30. But defensively, I think you'll see. We try to press a little bit, try to wear some time off on the defensive end. I thought our defense was excellent tonight. We held it to 25 or 24% shooting from the field, which is the best since we've been here. So I think with 11 block shots and defending, whether it's man and trapping press or his own press, the shot clock will come into effect at times and I think you'll see some teams press this year.
How do you think the freshman played
tonight? Benny had 3 fouls early, and then he settled down in the second half, played great in the second half, and Jimenez was just active all game. He had 5 block shots and made a couple of nice moves, so I was very happy with them. Got their feet wet in Division I basketball.
Andy, went out to, it was kind of close, you went out to a 15-3 surge there midway through the first half. What was the key to that as you saw?
We were just playing well as a team. We were defending, we were rebounding and pushing the tempo, and then we made some shots. So I thought that was really the key to the entire first half. We just have to just play, not think a whole lot, and just give great effort.
Well, what sort of advantages do you see when you're 3-guard sets?
With 3 guards?
Yeah.
Well, we start Jordan and Julian together. They're so-called point guards. They both play on and off the ball. They're lead guards, I should say. So I think it's hard to guard 2 guys that can put the ball on the floor and create scoring opportunities for their teammates and themselves. You see how athletic Julian is, and Jordan's very quick. And so they both have very quick first steps, and they've become very very good floor generals, passing the ball at the right time. And so we have the luxury of playing them together, and also can rotate them in and play 2 true wings together if we want to go bigger.
May 2 and Borgman play together for a stretch? Do you plan to do that more this season?
I'm sorry?
May 2 and Borgman play together for a stretch in the second half? Do you plan to do that more this season?
Sure. They're interchangeable with our entire front line. And we moved Benny to the small forward position for about 5 minutes of the second half and went big with two real bigs, and Benny to the 3. So. They'll all play together at times throughout the year.
Were you surprised by the quality of rim protection you got from Chimezie in just his first game? He was all over the place. Right?
Well, I've seen him for 3 years now, so no. He's an elite athlete. He's great. He's got great timing on his rim protection, and he went up, and I think the last one he got about 2 feet above the rim. So to answer your question, no, I'm very proud of him because he's doing what he's supposed to do, and he really played well.
How much different does it make your defense to have a guy like there?
Well, we can press. We can gamble up a little more in the full court. We don't like to gamble too much in the half court because we get in foul trouble by rotating. But I think it helps with our pressure, and also if our guards do get beat, it's always nice a few times a game when we do get beat to have someone back there that can adjust a shot.
Elijah looked really good tonight, and there were a lot of reports that he was great in the offseason. What do you think has been the biggest change in this game?
He's a better ball handler. He's much stronger physically. He's a better defender. And he's more confident.
If you can attribute the confidence that you guys have, it seemed like all their shots, there was no hesitancy. It was very, a lot of confidence in everything.
Well, we try to, first of all, they've worked extremely hard. So I think they're confident in how hard they've worked in the weight room, on the court. We went to Italy in August. They had a nice bonding experience there. They got some experience, a game experience, even though it wasn't a real Division I basketball game. Had a great preseason. So they're just excited to play. I didn't have to raise my voice at all tonight, and don't plan on doing that. You know, just said, hey, go out and have some fun and play team basketball, and I thought they did that.
10 guys played 15 more minutes tonight. Do you expect to have a like very deep rotation for the season for the most part?
Well, the nice thing is we are deep at each position, and I think the rotation will work it out, work its way out on its own, work itself out on its own. I think some nights some guys will have it going, and other nights other players will. And so we are deeper this year, and we're better at each position.
This was the largest margin of victories since you've been coach here. I know this is one game, and it was a non-conference game, but differently for you tonight, just in terms of how dominant you guys were on both sides?
We felt differently because we're a better basketball team. We have more talent. We're playing better as a team. It is just one game, but I'm very proud of that one game, because this is kind of, after you go through 30 days, 30 practices, and 42 days of preseason, it's nice to go out and play someone different than yourself. I thought our players were excited to be here and really go out and show how hard they've been working. So it feels different. We're a better basketball team.
Well, Coach, if I read the stats correctly, I think was Elijah's first career double-double tonight?
Probably was. I've been trying to get him to rebound. He's a big-time athlete, running and jumping, and we need that on a consistent basis. So we're not. A lot of our bigs are boxing out, and we need our guards to be great rebounders this year. And we made that a goal for Elijah to improve in that area, and hopefully that will continue.
The margin of victory was pretty large today, but were there any sort of improvements that you could see the team making for the next game?
Well, I just thought that. I thought we took a couple contested shots. I thought we were sloppy down the stretch. We had some. Our turnovers were down. We only had 5 at halftime. I thought the last 3 or 4 minutes that we made like 4 or 5 careless turnovers. And I just don't like to be careless at any time. So I'm not going to be picky. I thought overall we played really well, both ends of the ball. But those are the two areas I would say.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks for coming in an early game on a Friday night.